I believe art in America has been corrupted.
Oh, yeah.
You know, I mean, my feeling is not all art is designed to take home and hang it on the wall behind your couch.
No.
And not all art is designed to give you a nice, warm, cozy feeling. Art's job is to evoke an emotion and a feeling out of you. That's what art's all about, is to try to make the connection between the physical and the emotional, this thing we call love, or we call hate, or we call fear. I mean, how do I explain those things with words, you know?
Or spiritual.
Right, right. You have to feel them, and that's art's job. And also an artist's job is to document the life around them to other generations in whatever way it is, you know? I mean, Andy Warhol had his perspective, you know, and Michael D'Angelo had his perspective. That's cool, you know. I mean,
yeah, I think that for every century, you know, that we come through, you know, God has so many people on the planet, you know, that we're supposed to be artists, you know. Hopefully I'm one of them.
You're a milestone, dude. Mm. Just like Hendrix was, you made a change. And after you did your early thing, after you did some of the things that you did, vocally, emotionally, physically, or some of the bases that you touched, or whatever, some of the doors that you opened, and maybe just some of the windows that you opened and you just got a glimpse through, or whatever, if you hadn't taken those chances, done some of the things that you and the Seeds did, these other bands that were after you would have never happened. And some of the things that people call new wave and punk and stuff would have never happened.
Wow, thank you. What a really great compliment.
Well, it's a fact. I mean, God bless you. It's a fact.
I thought I was going to die the other day. I was looking at my life, you know. We're so close to dying. You know, I couldn't even breathe, you know. I don't know what it's from, you know. But all I know is I had some, you know, sacred herb. And I knew if I went to the hospital, they wouldn't give me any sacred herb.
Uh-huh.
So I just held on. So, you know, I think, you know, we're really a product, man, of what we've been taught through the system. You know, like I think most of the movies are lies now. Because I went to Europe, and I found people are really beautiful, you know. So, like, if you think that I did something good, then it was my destiny to do something, you know. Because I think music is probably the last thing we've got left. And now that we got internet, that's so great. Let me tell you something that might help you out.
What's that?
Of course, people won't believe it, but it's the truth. You know, like, you know, my spiritual father told me that, you know, told us that, Yehovah. He said, like, you know, you're looking at somebody, you know, like, I don't know, like, you know, there's another woman, and like, you like, what, did you like look at her in lust, you know? Do you know what I'm saying? Or like, why did you even look at her? Like, I seen you look at her. Like, why did you look at her? You know what I mean? Have you ever, I imagine everybody's been there.
Yeah.
Why'd you look at her? And you know, the only answer you can give, you know, if you're conscious, is because God is in you. God is always looking at his creation, you know. Like,
yeah.
God is inside everyone. You know, the I Am presence is in everyone. So it can't help but taking everything that's around it because it's all a creation. You know? So I don't know what to say to people. Get a life. You know,
anything that happens around my sensory input or what area, you know, that breaks me out of my norm is welcome to me. You know, I mean, you know, anything out of the watching a child play or you know, watching a bird have trouble with a
worm. It's all God, right?
Yeah, right. I'd rather, you know, instead of coming home and just hypnotized in front of the TV.
So what is nature then?
Nature.
When man says nature, is it nature?
What is nature?
No, what is it? When man says it's nature, what is it really? It's all Yehovah. Just like you say everything is everything, it's all Yehovah when you have the name.
Okay.
So everything is Yehovah. Everything is the Spirit. You know, so we're all connected, you know. Like, but it seems like it takes centuries for people to even figure that out, you know. That's why I think mankind should just bow down to the dog, you know, because he's the most noble. You know, the dog, the wolf, you know, the most noble of all mankind, you know, so why not bow down to them and serve them now, you know?
See, you know...
You know, the God within you serves the God, you know, the God, you know, like, I don't know. It takes a brick building to fall on people for them to even get any consciousness, but...
Well, see, what you know, you got to realize hundreds of years ago, the American brain was consciously... And it took years, you know, centuries for it to finally come to full effect, but I think it has now, has been slowly numbed.
Oh, yeah.
To make it possible for them to go out and massacre tribes of Indians, for them to go and chain black people up to trees and make it possible for them to, okay, we're finished with the Chinese, they built the radio, but, I mean the railroad, but we don't need them anymore, you know. So to do these terrible atrocities, to go and lock up their Japanese neighbors when Pearl Harbor got bombed.
I think people got to start with vegetarianism first. You know, if they can grasp that, then maybe they'll have a chance to save their soul, their spirit, you know, maybe save it.
How long has it been?
I don't see how anybody can make it without being a vegetarian.
How long has it been since you've had a piece of meat?
Yeah, I don't know, probably all my life, I guess.
Really?
5 years or so. Are you a vegetarian?
Me? No, I live in the beef state.
Oh, no.
I'm not letting it awful.
Yeah, because you won't be going to heaven. You'll go someplace else.
You think if you eat meat?
Some guy want to attack me. He says, well, I'm, you know, like really literally want to beat me up, because I said, well, like figure it out, man. I'm not be going with you. You eat animals. I don't. Like, why would I go to the same place you go? And he says, well, I'm judging him. And I said, well, judge yourself, you know. Like, no, really. Like, if you stopped eating today, maybe then you'd be forgiven. But see, the thing is that if you don't stop and you die, then it's too late. Look, if I feed you meat, then you won't eat dessert. You know, if you eat meat, you won't eat dessert because your I am won't allow you to eat it, you know. So, see, look, you have your two beings. You could record this if you want, but you have your two beings. One is your spirit and one is your soul, you know. Everyone has it, the spirit and the soul. But if the soul dictates to the spirit what it has to eat, then they both become the soul. They both become lost. Spirit becomes clouded with the soul, you know. But if the spirit can feed the soul what it wants to eat, you know, which is, you know, organic, you know, nothing meat, red meat, then they both work in harmony, you know, but they're still there, you know, the spirit and the soul. The only difference is, and it's such a great difference, is that the spirit has command of the soul instead of vice versa. So everything that wants to war and that goes to war is the direct thing. Because they eat red meat, because they eat meat, period, you know. And every illness we have on the planet is because they eat red meat, including AIDS, including all of it. They'll never get rid of AIDS until they stop eating red meat. And